Okay guys, today we will see this revolve, sweep, skin loft option. I'll change units to millimeter. Okay, so it is millimeter now. Take XY plane, start sketching. I'll make one rectangle. I pick revolve, so by default sketch has been chosen. Then axis, I will choose this axis, apply, generate. So this is how revolve operation works. I can also revolve up to some 180 degrees. Then generate, so it's 180 degree revolve, and all the options, add frozen, add materials, are available in this. So it is a simple operation. Now suppose I modify the sketch. Let me choose a different axis now. I will use this line as an axis, and this sketch I am going to revolve. This will be axis. Now I'll again go to revolve option, edit selection, apply, I will use this edge and generate. So yeah, so now like that you can generate tube by 360 degree rotation. You can generate a tube. Okay, so this is a revolve operation. Let me delete this. I'll delete sketch also. Now we will see the sweep operation. I'll sketch in XY plane. Let's draw one rectangle. Then I will go to YZ plane. Then I will draw a spline. Okay. Let's draw some spline. Then I will say this is open in spline. Yeah, this spline is visible now. Now this sketch 3 is a spline, sketch 2 is a this rectangle. Now I will go to sweep operation, profile is sketch 2 and path is sketch 3. And this just generate it. It is giving error. Now we can see what is the error. Profile produces self-intersecting geometry. This feature. Okay, so I will modify the sketch, delete, and let me put this as a line modeling, then generate. Yes, it has generated. So the error which was there when it was getting swept, it was self-intersecting, so it was not possible to sweep with that much curvature. That's why it was showing the error. Now we will again modify this H3. I will delete this line and again I will draw a spline. I do a spline option. Now I will not big curvature. I will use only simple curvature now. Then let me see what it does. Yeah, it has done now. So the curvature was not very steep, so it has done this sweeping operation successfully. Now I go to again this sweeping operation. Now if you see this face is not parallel with this face, it has done path tangent way. Okay, so if you want that to be a parallel, then you should change the polar axis. Then if I generate, now you can see both are parallel. Now you can also provide a twist. For that you need to give a pitch or turns. Suppose you want to model a spring, you can use this option, but here it will not be that much good. I'll just give you an example. So this is the way it is actually. It is actually spiraling about this path, so which is not that much good here, but after a little bit of calculations you can model spring. For spring we need to use a straight line as a path and circle as a profile, and that to be circle with some angle. So this is just I am showing how it is doing. Okay. So this is about the sweep operation. I will delete this sweep operation, and now I will focus on skin or loft. Now I will again go to XY plane. And I will draw some sketch here. I will draw a rectangle. Wrong rectangle here. I have finished the sketching on this plane. Now I will generate another plane which is offset to this XY plane. To do this, just go to XY plane, then create new plane. So for this new plane, it is using XY plane as a base plane. I am generating plane 4 using XY plane, and I will just translate this actually in Z direction. This plane 4 I will translate in Z direction, offset in Z direction 70 mm. Yeah, so this plane 4 is now offset 70 mm in Z direction with respect to XY plane. Okay, so now on this plane I will sketch another rectangle. Okay, yes, now we have two sketches, sketch 4 and sketch 5. Now I will select these two sketches, select sketch 4, control sketch 5, both are now selected. Then click on skin loft, It is now showing that this point will be related to this point. And accordingly, then this point will be on to this point to this point, and this point to this point. This we need to check always. Then I will say apply and then generate here. So this is what we have generated with skin or log pressure. Now what I will do, I will change this sketch file. Again go to sketching. I will delete this rectangle. Okay, and then I will delete this skin operation. We'll do again. So now I will go to again sketch file, and there I will generate a circle. Okay, I have generated a circle on offsetted plane. Now let's do the skin lock operation. Let's see what happens. Just skin locked. Okay, it is now showing one warning. The sketches for skin profile must have equal number of edges. Now problem is that this sketch 4 has 4 edges. The sketch 5 is a single edged sketch. So it is not possible to do this operation because it can't find out the correspondence between points. Okay, then I will delete this skin operation and then I will modify this sketch. So what I will do, I again go to sketching and then I will click modify, then I select split. Then I will choose this point, circle is split at this point, then I will choose this second point, yes it is split, this third point, and this is the fourth point here. Now it is a four curved sketch. Then I can go to sketch 4, sketch 5. Skin locked. Yeah, it has automatically given a correct correspondence. I will do I will go generate. Yes, this is how skin locked operation works. This skin locked is useful mostly for aerodynamic profiles generation. Like if you want to generate Naka profile pin or wing, in this operation skin lock operation is very useful in that. With this I will stop now. Have a good day.